We love having Jamie Dunn on the show with us. He's hilarious. And, of course, he is the brains and the hand behind Agro.
Now, you should tell the truth, because you said to
it's
me...
It's a lovely dolly.
Have you got your doll?
I know. No, I didn't mean that. It's a puppet. That's right. Now, we wanted to take the opportunity to find out a little bit more about Agro, the bath mat with eyes, and we've invited our very own Robbo on the panel, because he claims to be Agro's number one fan.
I am the number one fan. Number one fan. I really am.
Now, how, Jamie, before we get to the fan status of Robbo, How did Agro come to life, come to be?
Okay, there was another, you can gasp at the end of this
sentence. When one hand puppet loves another hand puppet.
You need to gasp at the end of the sentence. I wasn't the first Agro. No, there was another guy did him, Gary, did him for a year or so. And Channel 7, he and 7 parted ways. And I used to be a songwriter. And I'd written a song for Fiona and Agro. And I'd copied his voice in the middle, like, "Oh, Fiona, little furry guys like me," just like that. And of course, they rang me on the Friday night and said, "Will you do the show Saturday morning live television?" Wow. And in our business, Denise, don't we? Yep. We say yes first and work out how to do it later.
Yeah, exactly.
And so I just turned up at the studio, practiced the voice all night, and got it down pat, and I was lying on the floor going, you know, we got the Smurfs, we got the Snorks, and we got the Flintstones, we're giving away a trampoline. And Ian Duncan, the program manager, crawled across the floor and held up a sign which said, "Can you please make the puppet's mouth move when he speaks?" So,
the voice down pat.
Yeah, I was kind of relaxed with it right from the start.
Now, of course, Agro's main gig was introducing cartoons, but he had a lot of other jobs as well. One I remember in particular, but what other jobs has he done?
Oh, well, like I say with Denise, that's why I've got a connection with Denise, because to last a long time in this business, you've got to say yes to everything. I've done, you name it, I've jumped out of cakes with the puppet on my arm. It was a very big cake because I was very fat at one stage. I've done, and even just recently, you know, those car commercials and just bits and pieces, wherever there's a till.
I remember when he hosted Tonight Live with Steve Eisen, which was the biggest show in the world at the time.
I loved it.
I just thought he was... Because Agro was the biggest star at the time.
I loved it. You know why I loved it? Because that happened because I was sitting backstage at the Ecca in Brisbane with Steve Vizard, and it was just me and him, and we were just bagging everyone we worked with, like we did in television. But he wasn't anyone then, and nor was I. And he... Within, I don't know, 6 months, he was the biggest name in Australian television. And he called me and said, "Will you do Friday nights? I'm going to take Fridays off." And I thought, oh, well, what a great opportunity. Ooh, yeah. I said, "Yes, of course I will."
I could see Agro hosting a late night show now. Political edge.
I dressed Agro exactly the same as Vizard, with the tweed jacket, the leather patches. And there was people coming in from overseas that don't know Agro and being interviewed by him, having to look down. "G'day, welcome to Australia."
Could it happen again, do you reckon?
If you brought him back now, you'd have the little generation and you'd have the other generations. Yep. It would go. It would be fabulous. Yep.
I agree.
Yes. Yeah. Well, we decided we'd do a show
I'm also
called.
Available.
What was our show going to be called? We discussed it. Yep. Food Court. We thought that could go.
I'm going to be the cleaner.
I've got some character.
Now, Robbo, you're a very big fan of Agro.
I've got to tell you,
part of your childhood.
A huge part of my childhood. I remember when Jamie first came when we did our 60 years of TV special, and it was just the most amazing thing. And then it was, don't take this as a weird way, but as I was looking at you talking, like, again, I'm very excited to be on the couch with you. And that's not even saying I'm thrilled, absolutely thrilled. So I thought I'd bring some of my stuff. Hello. Now, the biggest thing that I loved about when you would do Agro, you'd always say that he was in a bag.
Yes.
And so I always remember thinking that as a kid, I thought, what bag is that? What's in the bag? But first, we'll go from the beginning. This is my first ever Agro doll.
Like,
where are we going?
Okay.
Yeah. That's my first ever one.
Let me jump in.
Yes.
We made that in China. And it actually is a lion's body with an Agro head. So they chopped all the heads off the lions and put Agro on there.
But the great thing is that his mouth opened. I don't know why I was excited about that. But That's what the great thing about it was. Yeah, yeah, great. Yeah.
The next thing was...
Don't just throw it down. No, no. Bring it up here. I'll have it.
Hold to that.
The probably next been thing late, was... but if any kids are watching, turn off now.
Yeah. The next thing was... Seven Super Saturday Show, which is what you did in Brisbane, which was an amazing thing. I had a sharpener that had Seven Super Saturday Show, which I never used to sharpen pencils because I thought it was too cool to do it. The next thing happened was I got my first ever compact disc, my first ever CD, Kids. Oh. It's a thing that has music on it. And it was this one. It was the Agro album, which was just the most amazing thing that I'd ever received. Oh. It was so cool. I think we can hear a song from it now, which was Your Theme. I have played this song more times than you would ever care to remember. And so does my friend. The next thing was now.
Yes.
Now, the next thing was, of course, was around 1990, when I was 7 years old, they created a puppet that you could buy yourself. And this is the only Christmas present that I ever remember opening. I can still remember it now. I opened it at my grandmother's house at Christmas morning, and it was this thing. It was just the coolest thing that I've ever had before. There it is. And it was just the most amazing. And I used to get out of school so I could do Agro shows with the Agro album, and they'd let me get out of school and say, oh, David's doing
can you do your
Agro shows.
Voice?
I never did an Agro voice, only ever mind. No, because the guy's here.
Yeah, I'm here. Hang on.
He's not dead yet. Oh, this is the most amazing thing. I'm so excited about this. I'm so excited. I was hoping this would happen. So when I was about 7 years old, I went to Red Bank Plaza, which is near Ipswich, and Mum said, he's there. I'm like, oh no, is he there? And I went up onto the stage, and all he said, Agro said, kiss me on the nose. Do it.
Kiss me on the nose.
Oh! The moment, as a seven-year-old, it was so good. And this is truly a dream come true, because I remember watching Agro, and the thing about Agro was that you thought you were in on the joke with him. It wasn't a kid's show that talked down to you. It was a kid's show that you were in on the joke.
Yeah.
And even as a seven-year-old or an eight-year-old or a nine-year-old, 10-year-old, whatever, you always thought that Agro, you were in on it with him. It was just the best thing, and he was just different to everything else on television.
Oh, you're just lovely. You're just lovely.
And truly, truly, and I absolutely loved it. And whenever he would do things like Celebrity Family Feud or Celebrity Wheel of Fortune, that show was on in our house. Aww. Honestly, it was amazing. To be here today, I'm not even kidding, it is the coolest thing that I've ever
You're
done.
You're losing your mind a little bit, aren't you? Well,
it's so cool. To do this right now, can you give us a minute,
Denise, can you just mind him? Watch his neck.
Oh, gosh.
Hold him like a baby.
Oh, hang on, where's the other one?
Hold him like a baby. Hold him like a baby. Be very careful. He's breastfeeding.
I just love him.
Oh, he's and amazing.
If you really look at those eyes, if you stare at the eyes, they look real.
They do. Yeah.
They do.
But don't you reckon as well, part of the beauty and the magic of Agro was that he was a bit naughty.
Yes.
And the outtakes on YouTube, which you said earlier, have clocked up more than 2 million views.
2.2 million hits they've had. It's just amazing.
Wow. Mm. Can I ask, because, you know, we were talking before about Mickey Mouse and whatever, are there any restrictions? What sort of restrictions are put on him?
His own lock, stock and barrel by Channel 7. Right. Yeah.
So and what are some of the things that he can't do? Are there any
I don't think he can appear on Channel 10. Just
he's not appearing.
Give him back.
Because he's just here.
He's so cute.
You stay there. You stay there with mummy, darling. Yeah.
Mm. But to any Channel 7 executives coming to collect him, I ask you, who is the real Agro? Mm.
Mm. I'm pretty sure they can. Let's put them together.
Can I just ask, there would only be one of him.
There's actually two of him. I did Perfect Match with Shelley Craft. And Grundy's thought that he looked too grubby, and so they made another one. And that's the second one.
You're not grubby, darling. Wow. You're beautiful.
But Robbo, you've got to have personality to do a puppet, mate. You're buggered.
Thanks for sharing the secrets of Agro, Jamie, and thanks for bringing your dollies in too, Robbo.
Yeah, you're welcome.